Here, school assembly is progressing on. Students are saluting our national flag. We all might see this scenario in our school. Can you guess what would be the height of the flag post held in the ground? This is the world's highest mountain, the Mount Everest. Can we measure its height on the whole? Here, two flights are flying in the sky at different altitude. Can we find the distance between them? This is a cliff near the seashore. A lighthouse is built on that cliff. Shall we try to find the height of the lighthouse from the sea level? Here, two ships are arriving towards the seashore. A man is watching those ships from the lighthouse. Can we find the distance of the lighthouse from the sea level? Alright, can all this be done with measuring tape? Not really possible. But the concept of trigonometry in mathematics make all this possible. Trigonometry deals only about right triangles, and the word would be splitted as trigonometry, which means three angle measurement. Pythagorean theorem defines the fundamental relations among the three sides of a triangle. That is, in a right triangle ABC, AC square is equal to AB square plus BC square. In triangle ABC, opposite to angle B 90 degree is the side AC, hypotenuse. AB is the opposite side to theta, and BC is the adjacent side to theta. For easy understanding, here a ladder is placed on a tree from the ground, which makes a right triangle. Ladder is the hypotenuse. Tree and the distance between them are the other two sides. Theta is the angle made by the ladder with the ground. This is a perfect example for the right triangle. And we remember the angle sum property, which says all the three angles of a triangle make 180 degree. That is, angle A plus angle B plus angle C is equal to 180 degree. If we imagine a flower with 6 petals and let the petals indicate the 6 ratios, then we could see the ratios like this: sine theta, cosine theta, tangent theta, cosecant theta, secant theta, and cotangent theta. Moreover, sine theta and cosecant theta are reciprocal to each other. Then cos theta and secant theta are reciprocals, and tangent theta and cotangent theta are reciprocal to each other. Can you guess what are these things here? These are the set square in your geometry box, which are an exact right triangle shape. With all the above mentioned sides and angles, we can write 6 basic trigonometric ratios. In right triangle ABC, sine theta is equal to opposite side by hypotenuse. Cos theta is equal to adjacent side by hypotenuse. Tan theta is equal to opposite side by adjacent side. And the reciprocal ratios: cosecant theta is equal to 1 by sine theta. Secant theta is equal to 1 by cos theta. Cotangent theta, that is cot theta, is equal to 1 by tan theta. Now, we are viewing an astounding railway bridge in Tamil Nadu, which is built over the sea level. The bridge connects the town of Rameshwaram on Pomban Island. This is a cantilever bridge which can be opened up to let ships to pass through at times. This is the most famous Howrah Bridge in West Bengal, with a suspended span over the Hooghly River. And this is the most beautiful Bandra Worli sea link in Mumbai, which is the largest sea link in India. Surprisingly, why all these bridges are made up of triangles? When forces apply to a shape like a rectangle or any other, it would be flattened out or broken easily. Whereas, when forces applied on triangles, it will evenly distribute weight and the construction will be more stronger. Generally, we use protractor for noting angles like 0 degree, 30 degree, 60 degree, and 90 degree, and so on. In particular, in the field of trigonometry, right triangles of ratio 30 degree, 60 degree, 90 degree, and 45 degree, 45 degree, 90 are used to find trigonometric values. Take an equilateral triangle ABC of side length 2a units and let all the three angles be 60 degree. Draw the median AD which bisect the side BC and angle A into A units and 30 degree respectively. Apply the Pythagorean theorem which gives AC square is equal to AD square plus DC square. Then length of AD is equal to A root 3 units. These are the two right triangles of different ratio with different side length. By using this side length, we can find trigonometric values for different angles. For example, sine 30 degree is equal to 1 by 2, cos 30 degree is equal to root 3 by 2, and tan 30 degree is equal to 1 by root 3. Finally, these values are tabulated and are used in problem solving. This is one of the tallest building in New York in USA, named as Flatiron. The entire 22-storied building is in the triangular shape. It reminds the steel-framed landmark of USA. For using trigonometry in real-life situation, we have to come across few terms which are as follows. This is a traffic signal in a busy road. A boy is going to help an old woman to cross the road through zebra crossing. He is viewing the signal. When we view an object, the line of sight is a straight line from our eye to the object. The other is horizontal line. If the object is above the horizontal line, we have to raise our head to view it. The angle formed by these two lines is angle of elevation. Now, the traffic police see the boy from the other side. The police is taller than the boy, so the line of sight is below the horizontal line. The angle formed in between these lines is called the angle of depression. It is important to note that the angle of elevation of an object is same as the angle of depression. Here is one more example. A boy spots a balloon moving with the wind in a horizontal line. The angle of elevation is 60 degree. After some time, from the same point of observation, the angle of elevation reduces to 30 degree. Now, we can find the distance covered by the balloon during the interval by using tangent ratio. What is this instrument you are looking here? This is the precision optical instrument called theodolite, which is used for measuring angles between visible points in the horizontal and vertical plane. And this is an inclinometer or clinometer, which is used for measuring angles of slope, elevation, or depression of an object with respect to gravity's direction. These instruments are used to measure the height of tall things that you cannot possibly reach, for example, top of the flagpoles, buildings, mountains, and trees. Thus, trigonometry plays a key role in our day-to-day lives.